I welcome you all. I'm Arno Hellemans. I'm the IPM and pollination specialist within the international team. And today we're going to have a little talk about controlling moths with the high-tech monitoring tools in the high-tech vegetables. So first of all, let me introduce BioBest to you. In 1987, a veterinarian, Roland de Jonge, started the business with the bumblebees in tomatoes. Nowadays, 35 years later, we are based in nearly 70 countries with 24 subsidiaries and more than 120 distributors and approximately 1,700 employees. Our product portfolio is very wide, from pollination to biological agents like beneficials as mites and insects, and also monitoring and scouting products and biopesticides. Scouting and monitoring are vital to success of IPM programs. It gives you the extra data and tools to make decisions easier. In the pictures you see conventional methods. Pointer. Conventional methods like traps, sticky traps, black holes, yellow sticky traps. We will normally place them in particular places like entry points, vents, or doors, or special rows. But also we have the crop scouting, walking in the crop day by day. But pests that are more active in the night, nocturnal population size can be underestimated. For example, Chrysodexis adults, they are nocturnal, so we will not see them if the population is still low. The first install larvae of Chrysodexis, they are very difficult to detect on the underside of the leaves. Also, we have pheromones like isoniazid on this red tube on the wire, but also delta traps and also water traps we have in our portfolio. And UV lamps are also play a very important role in monitoring and catching spots. But what are the most important moth pests that we scout for in vegetables? I will give you a clear insight. So we have Chrysodexis, common name Turkish moth in Dutch, tomato looper in English, and Chrysodexis, it stands for shiny gold. And I want to show you, if you look on the left picture on top, you see on the wing the golden shiny spot on its wing. Also the gold brown of the two pearlescent spots on the wing inside of the golden. So on the picture below you can see the pearlescent spot. Also what makes them typical is the hairy combs on the back of the moth when they are at rest. And they are semi-nocturnal animals. They avoid daylight, so they would not like to fly in the day, only when they are disturbed. They are very common in greenhouses. The caterpillar is highly polyphagous and feeds on plants from more than 20 families. The caterpillar has three pairs of abdominal legs, like you see on this picture, and two on the other side. It allows the caterpillar to propel itself in the same way as a tension caterpillar can do. So what is Chrysodexis? What makes the damages made by Chrysodexis? If you can see on the picture, it eats from the fruits, leaf damage, several pictures, and also the contamination of the frass excrement on the fruits that also gives economical damage for the growers. So what is Chrysodexis? The development and the lifespan. In the the top bar, you see the different stages of the mod. You can see X lasts from 4 to 6 days to hatch. Hatch rates can go up to 90%, and they are not that are normal for Cryosodexes. The 6 to 7 larval stages, the caterpillar changes skin every time when it changes from larval stage, 6 to 7 larval stages, and need 2 to 3 weeks to change from the total pupils to the pupil stage. The pupil stage takes 2 weeks. And then the adult stage is around 1.5 week, and the female can lay up to 400 eggs. And very important, they have almost 9, they are capable for 9 generations per year. Also Tuta Absoluta. Tuta Absoluta, tomato leaf miner. The adults are grayish brown, that are approximately 6 to 10 millimeters in length, and have a 10 millimeter wingspan. Males are slightly darker in color than females. The adult moths are often silvery brown with small black spots on their forewings, like you can see on the pictures, and fringes on the hind of the wings. If it's very clear for everybody, but on the end of the wings, you see the fringes. It looks like damaged wings. Also, the antennae, they are quite long and they reach beyond half the body. Also, what you can see on the picture. The eggs are yellowish brown and colored by age. The older they become, the darker they will be. The caterpillars also change color as they age, from yellow to yellowish green. And the good remark is that they have darker band behind the head of the caterpillar. That's what you can see on the picture here. The head is dark and there's a darker band behind the head. The damage Tuta makes is in general in the leaves. In the picture, what you can see now in the middle is damage from 2 insects. On the left, you can see leaf miner damage, and on the right, you can see Tuta damage. The difference between those two is that the leaf miner, his vras is in the mine, and from the Tuta, it's on one side of the gallery. When populations are high, you can also see fruit damaging and stem boring by Tuta. Tuta damage results in 50 and up to 100% yield reduction in tomatoes. So that's a quite big number. So what is Tuta? Tuta develops very rapidly. A total life cycle can be done within 5 weeks. Therefore, it's very important to take measures against this pest in advance. Females produce up to 260 eggs in their total lifetime. In optimal condition, they can have 12 generations per year. So that's every month a full generation. Because they are nocturnal, the first ones are always overlooked and hardly noticed. So moths are the basis for the problems with caterpillars. Because they are nocturnal, we don't see them in daytime with our monitoring and scouting techniques. We assume that threshold is level are lower than we expect. If threshold levels are high, preventative and curative measures will not work properly. Bacillus applications will be too late, too broad spectrum of larval stages, and then we need chemical applications instead. In case of mating disruption for Tuta Absoluta, this works only with low numbers of moths. If we have too many moths in the greenhouse, they will still find each other, they will bump up to each other, they will mate and they will reproduce. The adult stage is a small window of their life cycle, but an important one to control the pest. So all data gathered about this pest pressure is key to control the moths. And the biggest issue is that we normally don't see them because of their nocturnal lifestyle. Therefore, There is a demand on early detection system that is capable for real-time monitoring. Now we go to monitoring with the PAD system. And I will first explain you a little bit about the PADs and also the cooperation with BioBest. The PAD system is developed by PADs, a Dutch company, and we at BioBest have the product in our portfolio. So it's available to all our customers. Because scouting and monitoring is a very important task for a good IPM strategy, we work in close relation with the PADs team. The PADs C is a box the size of a small football. It has cameras on the front side that can record mods. And I'll show you here on the picture, the darker bar, there's where the cameras are inside. And below you can see an LED module that will eliminate night active insects with infrared lights. And last but not least, all this data that is gathered by the PADs C system is being transferred into a web portal where we can view all the data. Mods are detected on their size, but also on when they fly and how they fly. The list of mods can be detected, that can be detected, and for this crops, pepper and tomato, it's Chrysodexis, Dupongelia, and Tuta absoluta, that are most important ones in this crops. To install an PADC module, it only costs us 10 to 15 minutes. Wi-Fi is not needed because there's a telephone SIM card inside of it, so it will connect to the system. This is a graph of Chrysodexis in a tomato glasshouse. On the y-axis, you can see the individual counts of the mods. And on the x-axis, you can see the days throughout the year. A very nice example of several peaks. Here you have the first peak, first generation, second generation, and the third generation. And after everything, after the third generation, is a little bit more confused. Is it fourth or is it still the third? But you see every fifth week you have a new generation in the first period. Here is a good example of a tomato grower with Tuta absoluta. You can see very low numbers that the Delta traps didn't even monitor. This grower was using Isonet T, mating disruption for Tuta. This Isonet will not last forever. And you can see that in the graph. Isonet is finished here. It will not give the mate disruption anymore. So mods still can find each other. And from that moment on, you see the numbers climbing. Therefore, we now see the importance of scouting and monitoring. Here we have a next graph. On the y-axis, you can again see the individual counts of the mods. But now on the x-axis, you can see the hours throughout the day. This data shows two tomato greenhouses with 7 cameras in total. You can very nicely see when mods are flying. Here you have a peak activity at from 8 till 10 o'clock, and the second peak activity at 6 o'clock in the morning. The previous one was from Chrysodexis. The next one is from Tuta absoluta. If you compare that with Tuta, you still see the same peaks from 8 till 10 and from 6 in the morning. Only in between these peaks, there's also flights monitored. Very typical for Tuta, but it's low activity. Here is a little video from Tuta absoluta flying in a tomato crop. Very small dot flying above the crop. But how do we recognize mods in flight? In this video, you can see a Tuta mod flying, a very small dot, the flight pattern, the size of the mod, and the time of the flight tells us it's Tuta absoluta. The remark that I have to make is that we normally say Tuta flies below or through the crop, like a meter or a meter and a half, above ground level. But from all the data we have gathered, we know that Tuta flies in the night time above the crop, what we normally don't see in our scouting and monitoring while we go through the crop. Here's a short video of a tomato looper, Chrysodexis, flying above the crop. A little bit bigger than the previous Tuta. And also his flight pattern is very typical for Chrysodexis. The big advantage is working with the PATS C system, a very easy and quick view into the web-based dashboard. The faster you know pests are there, the quicker you can respond. Because of the detailed information the system gives you, you can track the population development. Due to all this detailed information, it is getting easier to learn about these pests. The web-based dashboard gives you a clear insight in the trend lines. This will help growers and advisors to adjust measurements and predict the next application. Saving money with a system like the PATS-C, crop walks for monitoring can be reduced. The system is its own administration. This doesn't need workers to put the data back into the computer. So the added value of PATS-C into the IPM system. Key for perfect IPM strategies means knowing what's happening. The earlier you know about a pest or a disease, the earlier you can respond to it. Very important info is to know the details of the pest. When you know it's active, you can respond to it. For example, turning on the lights, the lamps for catching the moths at the exact time of the night. The system does the job. It gives you detailed information with the same consistency day in, day out. Also, if you are aware of trends, you can adjust that and plan for the next season. So how does a PATS-C system look in a crop strategy? So we start with the nursery. From the nursery, the plants go to the grower. There, the PATS-C system is already hanging. This can also be already with the nursery. Very important one. Don't forget that. There we add our Macrolophus bugs. We feed them with our Nutrimac Plus or Nutrimac or Artemac. Moths start flying, the PATS-C system starts to detect, and we can now adjust our Bacillus thuringiensis sprayings of applications in the crop. This we can do the same for the pepper greenhouse. Start with the PATS-C system. Again, the Macrolophus is added. We feed them very properly. But still, it's possible for moths to come in. They are also detected. And also here, PT application is possible. Keep numbers of caterpillars low in the crop. So how do we deal with this data? We see a peak, the first peak of the first generation of moths. And ideally, we make two sprayings of BT applications. And the first one is at 2nd of April. And approximately 7 to 10 days later, the second application will be there, around 10 of April. And then you can prevent next generations to develop. If you are on the right moment, on the right time, this can help your situation. The take-home message. Effective scouting can drastically improve IPM programs. PATS-C can aid early detection of pests, increasing efficacy of bioinsecticide performance through early application. Preventative and curative approach enables you to take the right measures at the right moment. Frequent monitoring and early detection systems are key for success. PATC and BioBest provide these tools into the market. Early intervention gives growers opportunities for healthier and residue-free crops. Thank you for listening.